everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. The Seahawks have battled back and made it to 500. And now they'll try to move past that mark today. It's the Buccaneers going up against the Seahawks. With that, let's get you up to Seattle. We're standing by are our commentators, Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
Okay, Larry, we are just south of historic Pioneer Square at CenturyLink Field in the beautiful city of Seattle, Washington. Tonight, we reach the unofficial midway point of the season with a good Monday night battle between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Seattle Seahawks. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
And that's how you get started and open up a game. Really well-blocked play. Picked up a nice chunk of yardage. If you're the offensive line, that's exactly what you've talked about all week long in your meetings. Establish the line of scrimmage and take control. And they gave their running back plenty of room to rumble.
First down throw for Winston. And Austin Seferian Jenkins has it. And he's brought down. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
I know I'm not in the rooting business, but I really like this kid, Austin Seferian Jenkins. Good catch there. I'm just hoping he can stay on the field and have some good health.
Now the Bucs hoping so, too. Limited to 16 games total his first two seasons combined.
He is quite a target for a young quarterback. Jameis Winston can grow with this guy, and boy, they can be a dynamic duo.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he stopped immediately there. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second down. And Jenkins is a guy in this offense that I know you like to talk about.
Absolutely love to talk about Austin Seferian Jenkins. His ability to play in any position, whether it's as a wide receiver or as an inline tight end, his versatility, some of the best in the league.
You even gave him the full name there.
Austin Seferian Jenkins. He is the real deal.
Second down, Winston. It's caught by Mike Evans. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. And that's the first connection. The number one overall pick in 2015, finding the number seven pick in 2014 in Evans.
And what a great target Mike Evans is for Jameis Winston. Winston's a pretty accurate thrower, but that catch radius that Evans provides, that makes him that much more dangerous.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36.
No matter what defense is called versus a running play, linebackers are telling the defensive guys up front, you take care of the offensive line, keep us uncovered, let us run to the ball, we'll make big plays. Well, that paid off there. All the guys up front, the big fellas, they controlled the five offensive linemen. That allowed the linebackers just see the openings, sprint through the gap, and snuff that play out in a hurry.
Left side complete, Seferian Jenkins. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine. Partner, your thoughts on this D-line.
I love a unit that can control the run and get after the passer. This is an all-around terrific defensive front. Hard to move the ball against them on the ground, and then when you want to throw it, look out. Here they come after the quarterback.
Ready, fire. Now Jameis on second down. This will be caught inside the 10. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal. And the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far on the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. 5 yards, a good run there, and now second and goal. Now this will be the ninth play on this drive. So that run gets him about halfway home.
Yeah, it's now second and goal. The end zone beckons. It looms. They can do whatever they want. Full playbook. Run it again, or they can go play action and try and put it in that way.
But good luck there as a ball carrier. You get handed that football. Look up. Oh, there's a big D tackle ready to swallow you whole for a loss.
Yeah, you kind of count on your guys to give you at least a little bit of time, a little bit of space to try and maneuver, but not on that.
And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Their dangerous wide receiver. His third touchdown now on the year. And the bucs take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. But he will not be able to bring this one back in the extra point attempt. Unsuccessful.
But there's a blocked extra point. I remember playing and we had one of those go against us. I remember our kicker and our holder told the head coach, just relax, coach. Why are you yelling? Don't worry about it. It's just one point. Oh, my. Those coaches see a point is gold to them because you never know how it's going to turn out later.
Exactly. That's why I was just going to say first quarter. We'll see if this has any implications as the game goes on.
Still can't believe they told the head coach to relax. Whoa.
Bad move. On first down. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And this will be caught at the 30. Good use of the pass there to pick up the first down against a defensive look that they had specifically prepared for, they told us, coming into this one.
Certainly seems like they're holding all the right cards now, doesn't it? Because of their preparation. Went back, watched the tape, studied the tendencies, and they feel like they had them down cold, and they were able to use the pass against them.
This is Rawls, and he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down. Then here's a look at the starting offense. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. Time running out here on the play clock. They snap it at one. Now Wilson. And at the 7 yard line, the catch is made. And he's brought down after a good game. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there. One back to the 5 yard line, but no further than that. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get him in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot on this drive.
And he will take this one in for the Seahawks touchdown. Thomas Rawls hitting double digits
with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Seahawks are now just an extra point away from moving out in front. And he puts it through. Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
I know the toss play begins with the guy taking the snap and turn around and tossing it to the runner. But where the real intrigue is, can they seal the edge, whether it's an offensive tackle or a tight end, in the direction they want to run the football? If they do that, that's the result that you get, that type of a game. If they don't, oftentimes it's not a very successful play.
To throw, Winston. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive. Jameis now on 1st down. A dump off to Sims. And at a 42-yard line here and brought down there. It's a 4-yard pickup, and it'll be 2nd down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Quick hitter here, it's complete. No gain on the play, and it'll bring up a 3rd down. The defense loves to hang their hat on that, don't they? You get a guy that catches the ball, but you stop him for no gain.
Without a doubt, because they're also used to
trying
to catch people after the catch, and they miss. And that turns into a huge play. We've seen it so many times. In this case, though, catch was made, put down right on the spot.
So 3rd down, just 1 yard to go. They come out here in the eye. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he will have the 1st down as he's brought
bullshit
down up near midfield. Only get 2 there, but on 3rd and 1, that's all they needed to keep the drive going. Attack here, and he gets this inside the 35-yard line. It's a gain of 17 that time, and it'll give the Bucs a 1st down. And on the ground they go with a running back, and he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the 1st down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive.
Ready. Ready.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a 1st down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
So the run moves the chains, and here we go on 1st down. And they'll go on the ground. And he
he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Two minutes to play here in the first half. Back to CenturyLink Field after this. So second and 10 here. They'll try to throw now. Winston. Into double coverage and it's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down into those starter's blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something because right now they're just cutting them to shreds.
On second down, Wilson. From the left side, it's complete. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. And that first down following that long gain. They'll hand to Rawls. And he's going to be met at about the 43. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8. And now the bucs deciding to take a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Second down, 8. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Rawls, the lone man in the backfield. Wilson. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's brought down. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. 12 yards on the pickup, and it's good enough for a Seattle first.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag because when you do, you just put the ball on it and then let him run.
Yeah, he's got some space. From the red zone now, here's Wilson on first down, and this will be incomplete.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. Again on second and 10, it's Wilson. And incomplete there, a nice hit, jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. Here comes the seventh play now of this drive as this is third and 10.
19.
On third down, Wilson. Into a double team and it's intercepted. Picked off by Bryce Callahan. And a short return to the 6-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. And that'll bring up second down.
Well, partner, I guess that answers the question about whether they're going to sit on it or not.
It does. Now we'll see if they try that again.
Yeah, I think what we find on plays like that, when you take that shot, if you're unsuccessful, then you go way more conservative to finish the half, you know? I think that's the way they'll go.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Down, Winston. He's going to let it go again, and it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Whenever I see a drop like that, I have to kind of take a step back and check myself a little bit. So used to seeing those big guys make big-time, spectacular plays that when they drop one, I have to remind myself, we ask a lot out of these guys. Block and catch the football, not easily done in today's NFL.
He's going to take another shot here.
This ball's
tipped and intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. The Seahawks offense now, they get set to go back to work. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Let's get out of there.
And tough starting field position here. They come out here in the eye. Rawls. And he's able to get this up just shy of the 15. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So as they take it over, we step aside. They stay on the ground. Rolls again. And he's going to be taken down here as that will lead us to the end of the first half of play. So we are at halftime here in downtown Seattle with the Seahawks out in front as we send you cross-country to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando. With our halftime report, here's Larry Ridley. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready.
About change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. Second half starts with a run by Rawls. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Now we're going to get a timeout. Appears we've got an injured Buccaneer. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside.
Steel beat Justin.
On second down, here's Wilson. Trying to lay one up deep. That's caught inside the 20.
Yes.
It's a big play there for Seattle. 58.
Oh, really?
Yards.
Cool.
So let's go ahead and add to the difficulties of guys trying to cover receivers. They got to deal with speed, shiftiness, all that stuff. But how about when they have height and length and deep downfield, you throw the ball up in the air? That's how they uncover at the end of a route, by being able to go up over the top and make a big catch.
They'll run with Rawls. And able to
push his way forward here for a good little gain. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Rawls, the lone man in the backfield. To throw is Wilson. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. A 5-yard gain, and now they're set up first and goal. Now it's first and goal. This is Rawls. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
So if I'm an offensive coordinator, there's one thing that I know for sure. This is one of the top 5 teams in the NFL against the run. So when I look at my playlist, I'm probably thinking about throwing it.
Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. They come up in an offset eye. Now Wilson on second down. And this one's incomplete.
It's not.
Good
it's
coverage
a...
there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Extra defensive back on the field here for third and goal.
Madden.
On third and goal, Wilson. His pass caught at the 4. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
And Hauschka's kick is good. And they bump the lead up to 4 now at 10-6. So put 3 on the board, but from inside the 5. And I know we use this phrase a lot, but that's a big-time win for the defense.
It sure is. You've got the short field behind you, so you can afford to turn up the pressure. And that was a nice sequence there to keep them out of the end zone.
Here comes the Buccaneers offense. They get their first reps of the second half. They trail the offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter 3, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
It's a nice completion and a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds. Because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs. 18 yards on the pickup there. And the Buccaneers are going to have a first down. They try the corner route there, Charles, and it works to perfection.
Boy, that's hard on a defensive back, because if you get any faker move to the inside, you have to respect it, and then the receiver breaks back to the sideline.
It's a gain of 6 on the play, and it's a second down. And now they're in the hurry up. To the air again with Winston. Caught, Seferian Jenkins, right side. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
Almost not fair. The big guy running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop it?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well, because his quickness often wins the route.
And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20.
As long as you go through your proper reads and progressions, the drag route can be one of those old reliable plays, because usually it's good for a good chunk of yardage, as we just saw there.
And those guys like it, right? They can get the ball with a full head of steam.
Especially against man coverage, because man coverage, they're typically running away from someone and not worried about traffic coming out on the other end.
And he'll push his way up to about the 14. A gain of 3, second down.
And here comes play number six on this drive. Now a second down throw for Winston. This will be caught at the two. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal.
Partner, they weren't quite in the red zone, but things are starting to get condensed on the field. Throwing the corner route there, really nice play because it gives them a little bit of room to complete it.
Play clock winding down. We're going to get a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Now they'll run it on the toss, and he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. A great play there. His sixth touchdown of the season. And the bucs are going to retake the lead. Solid job up front. Really just a solid job all around. That one in.
That was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result, 6 points.
Touchdown. The kicker, Roberto Aguayo, has it teed up and is about ready to get this one started. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
One receiver left, three to the right. Play clock winding down. Throwing is Wilson. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. They'll get a couple yards on that one, and that'll make it a second down.
I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old. You're only 65. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. On second down, Wilson. He's got time. Going up top. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Micah Hyde. And they're going to take over right there at the 22-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking
couldn't find
to do
my
that
play
again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counter-punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got to a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. Second down, Winston. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. It'll be a gain of six, and they're going to have a third down. Let's see what the defense dials up here. Third and four. Winston from the gun on third down. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. It'll be a pickup of just two, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. Here's Brad Nordman now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. And good hustle here as this is going to be blown dead right at the 9-yard line. And the Seahawks get ready to trot out on the field. And not great starting field position here for the offense. Counterplay, rolls, and nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, second down. And this defense continues to give them fits. They just can't get really anything going on the ground, can they?
I love the theme that you just brought up. This defense has been tough all game long against the run. We just saw another example of it there.
Second down, here's Wilson. And he's going to go down right near the goal line. The officials look at each other. They're going to mark him at the 1-yard line.
Oh, boy, he got a favorable spot there. The guys on the sidelines were raising their hands over their head and clasping their hands to signal safety. But the official marked it just outside the end zone at the 1-yard line.
So a big sack on second down. Now let's see what the offense has in store for third. Wilson from his end zone on third and long. He sets to... And Wilson's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Bryce Callahan. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They come out here in the eye. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
But they certainly got dented with that first down run. So now they've got to be back on their heels a little bit as a defense.
Second down following the run. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Now Jameis on second down. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. Partner, nothing complicated here. This is just a pretty simple drag route.
You're exactly right, Brandon. Instead of throwing it downfield, they just throw it underneath and let the receiver do the work.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Now a handoff here to his running back. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
All the elements of what you want out of
two fucking plays is fucking me up.
And even more importantly, taking the clock under 4 minutes now.
At this stage of the game,
how do you bleed out the clock? Take care of the ball and make sure the other team doesn't have a chance to come back on you. You're looking at your sheet, how many timeouts are left, how many runs do we need to close it out? That's what the coach is looking at right now. Situational football, trying to gain a victory.
They'll give it to him right up the gun. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. It'll be second down.
Well, he didn't make headway on that one, but he's had plenty of carries all night long. I just wonder if maybe he's a little bit tired from toting the rock that much.
Getting late here in the fourth, and if this team has any chance to win this football game, their defense obviously needs a stop here. From the shotgun, it's Winston. And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move all over the place to try and find good matchups, and they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
On third down, Winston.
And this is going to be incomplete.
Well, that was pretty nice to watch if you like the defense's perspective, because they understood where the first down line was as much as the offensive guys did. Did not give up any more ground, and when the ball was thrown, reacted really well and swatted it away. One of the advantages of zone defense, you never take your eyes off the quarterback, and when he reacts, you do exactly the same and go get the ball.
So they get the three here, but you wonder whether that's going to be enough.
Yeah, I mean, you've now made it so they need a touchdown rather than a field goal to catch them. But you're right. If they'd gotten six out of that drive, this would be a much different game.
The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. The offense certainly looking to score some points, but they also need ball security here late as we get down to the final moments of this one. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he powers his way up past the 30. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down. And quickly, they get to the line.
That kind of run on first down, that's a winning type of a run. That just sets things up for them moving forward as they begin the drive.
It's a five-yard gain, but they'll still be a yard short here with third down now looming. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. Now let's see, the bucs with six DBs, so a dime set here on third down. They run with a power back, rolls, and he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42.
Everyone understood their role on that play. Third and one, you know, the defensive guys, they're trying to get down and get low and get leverage on the offensive lineman, but they didn't allow that to happen. They created a crease and allowed him to get through for a first down.
And they give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now, because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. It's a pickup of six and good enough to move the chains. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. And he'll push his way up to about the 44 here. Gets a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run, because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. Now, whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Here's the seventh play of this drive. This is third and four. They'll look to throw. And a quick throw here. That's complete. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
Again, Rawls. He's been busy tonight. And he is in and
after that touchdown. And you and I both know what that means. Extra point in this situation, this little time left, takes on some extra emphasis, doesn't it?
It does indeed. Now inside the final minute, can they hold on? House get out is send this one away following the score. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll start things out at the 25. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you get a decision. Are you in field goal range, or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot that you're going to have another play.
We'll see how they handle it.
Well, any caused incompletion is good for a defense. But when you add to it, you get a little hit on the quarterback, knock him to the ground, make him think a little bit. hopefully knock him off his game, especially in a game of this magnitude, this tight in the fourth quarter. Got to feel pretty good as a defense.
He'll look to throw. And he comes back with one complete. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Back to throw. And that is incomplete.
On third and one, I think everyone in the stadium thought they'd try and run the football there, but they tried to surprise the defense and hit something through the air. Instead, it results in an incompletion.
Whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. Let's see what second down has in store. He's back to throw. Escaping the pressure right. He's going to let it fly. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. A great hit is picked off. And a big turnover there as his guy.
Boom! Boyaka, boyaka. Ja, 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 ja.
The clock cannot be stopped here. Defense can do it.
Motherfucker! No mesh, motherfucker! Shit!
Victory formation
in this. Biatch! Let's go! Fuck out! Woo!
Tools!
Fuck out! Let's go!
It's a loss of two there, bringing up second
down.
And Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Thanks. Match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you
hold thanks, baby.
They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.
Oh, yeah, it wasn't right. Thank you. Ooh, wee. Ooh, wee.
Thanks.
Charles Davis and all our crew. Ooh. I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. It's a win for the Seahawks here as we say so long from Seattle.
Thank you.
match be killing you, boy. God damn, boy. All right, let's look at these damn highlights. What we had here? Shit. Six. I like this. All right, boy. Xavier, you playing very good. Oh, man. Xavier, you playing very good for your boy. Playing very good. There you go, Rose. Get you a second interception. All right. I see you, kid. I see you. Coming in for Rose, man. That's why we signed you. That's why we put a second round pick on you, man. Because we like what we saw. We like what we saw over there, man. And we had to bring you over. There you go. See, that's what I'm talking about. That's why I'm talking about Xavier Howard. You know, Ro got hurt, and you came in. You stepped in. You taking that big thing from me. You good. That's what I like about you, kid. Like that. Rose got the only two touchdowns, but boy, he was doing it, boy. Way to go up the middle on that. Yeah. There you go, big dog. This is what you mean, clutch factor right here, Rawls. This is where we paid you some money. Clutch factor, kid. Hit him with the mesh, and then all of a sudden, oopie, good block. Oh, we gone. We out of there, homie. Do the old dance. Bully. Let's see. Here you go. We got to protect the mesh. We had to protect the mesh. Then we had to send him. But my man, Clifton, player of the week last week, getting it done. Zach Clifton. That's why we traded for you, baby. We knew it. We saw it. Way to seal the game for a brother. Woo. That extra point. Blocked extra point. Let me see that again, because that's what did it. That was the bugaboo right there. Let me. Right here. This is why you won the game. Special teams. Who came in here and did it? Was that you, Jeff Coke? Yeah, it was. Look at you. Come right in. Block it. Sherman, pick it up. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. That was the point. That was the block point right there. We need, after the big score came down there. Wow. He was on it too. Look at him. He's like, no. No. Give me that 1 point. Oh, man. That was nice. Woo-wee. Get up out of here, baby. Oh, man. Shit. Yeah, that's what I was doing in the 3-4. And were they, you know what? That's probably what was fucking me. I thought that I was putting them in hard. Because I was, he was getting quick. He was, yeah, he was hitting me quick with it. And I was like, fuck. But, man, woo. I couldn't stand it, man. He was meshing. Motherfucker said he changed his game. That motherfucker ain't changed shit. That motherfucker mesh kid. Huh? Yeah. Yeah, you know, I'm a B mesh. I was born. My daddy called me mesh. I was born mesh, so I'm a B mesh. That motherfucker, boy. All right. Dude, I was mad as hell. Remember that one fucking ball I had a touchdown, they called it out of bounds. I was mad as fuck. Man. Yeah, I was all over the place.